BP is announcing another snag in its attempts to permanently kill the well in the Gulf of Mexico. The static kill has stalled now again, and critical test is being delayed. This after a leak was found. WDSU News Washington correspondent Kate Amara is joining us live from our nation's capital with some new numbers showing just how much oil has spewed into the Gulf of Mexico. Kate, good morning.
Hey, good morning, Melanie. And because I know that you have been here throughout the 106 days of this, I know that you know that back on day four of the BP oil spill, the official government estimate was 1,000 barrels a day spilling into the Gulf. There are new government estimates this morning, and they are 50 times the initial estimate.
The BP oil spill in the Gulf of Mexico is the world's worst caused by an accident. That's according to a team of federal and independent scientists charged with calculating the flow rate. The panel says until BP's runaway well was capped on July 15th, 206 million gallons of crude oil spewed into the Gulf.
We're in a situation we've never been before in this country with the size of the spill. And we're learning things every day about the fate of the oil.
Massachusetts Congressman Ed Markey says if BP had owned up to the size of the spill from the beginning, the Gulf region would have been better prepared to fight it.
And that's why we have to ensure that internal bleeding inside of this ocean is monitored very closely.
Meanwhile, BP postponed work to permanently plug the well. The company said critical tests had to be delayed until a leak in the temporary cap could be fixed. National Incident Commander Thad Allen is downplaying expectations.
The static kill is not a monolithic thing that will happen today. It is a potential of one part of the diagnostic tests that are being done. It is not an end in and of itself.
BP says that test and possibly that static kill could get underway today. Live in Washington this morning, I'm Kate Amara, WDSU News. Melanie, back to you.
And Kate, 50 times the original estimate. This is why Gulf Coast residents are so hesitant in believing what they're hearing in terms of the estimate. Why do we keep seeing this official spill estimate increase?
According to the National Incident Commander, it's all about the data. He assembled this team back in May so that they could constantly refine the spill estimates as new data became available. These new numbers, we're told, are based on things like new pressure readings and new analysis of that high-resolution video from the cameras at the bottom of the Gulf, Melanie.
Oh, very discouraging for residents. Now, aside from, I guess, the obvious, the response and the cleanup, how will these new numbers be used from this point?
Well, here's something that you and I have also discussed before. These new estimates will be used to figure out how much BP could be fined for this oil spill. Mm-hmm. According to experts that we spoke to under the Federal Clean Water Act, BP's looking at a penalty of about $4,300 per barrel spilled. And if you do the math, it comes out to more than $20 billion. Possible penalty of more than $20 billion, Melanie.
$4,300 per barrel. All right. Kate Amara, thanks for that clarity this morning. From